Want to come back to what I was talking about, animate and inanimate. And man, in his earlier way, is saying he's very happy to then, he has different science, biology and chemistry and physics, all different. But suddenly microscopes got stronger and began to learn more and more. So gradually there was an overlapping. And by the time we came to World War II and scientists were being brought together in big war teams, we have saying, it's an amazing thing, you know, but I'm overlapping you, you're overlapping me. So they had to, while they thought they were going to be specialists, they suddenly find they had to be called biochemists, biophysicists. They had to put a hyphen there. So while man himself was trying to deliberately be more of a specialist, nature was pushing him together, saying you're all in the same boat. Now, the connection then between, say, biology, chemistry with molecules, biology with cells, and chemistry with molecules, and the physicist with his atoms. World War II saw all these people come together, and the overlapping of the whole soul. And particularly, we have the something as man began to try to understand the biology, and he finally got to something genes. He's very amazing. Here's the chromosomes. And we began to break this thing down even more, and right, some real chemical keys here. And yet, now he's overlapping his biology and his chemistry completely. He's getting extraordinary chemical compounds. And now we get to what it is you're pursuing, trying to understand design, which seem to be tied up with chromosomes and genes. You're pursuing that particular subject. And you're isolating more and more this particular phenomenon. We get down to what we call the virus. But tobacco mosaic virus was of very great importance. And in the area of the virus, we find nuclear physicists coming, we find mathematicians coming, we find biologists and chemists, all of them getting to meet in the virus level. Now, as everybody knows, that within the protein shell of the virus came to this nucleus, and within the nucleus you came to the DNA, RNA, we have the guanine, cytosine, GC, and thymine, and adenine. GC and TA, the A and the T and the G and the C always are together, taken upside down. So when it came to that beautiful genetic code of RNA, DNA, it was going to be GC, GC, TA, AT, you could reverse play the, there was a pairs, AT. Now these pairs are AT and GC, but because there are four of them, and not unlike the fact that four corners of a tetrahedron. And we get to where if you take tetrahedron, and triple bond them. As I take, remember I'm again picking up three fingers, and I'm going to take my right hand, my left hand, tetrahedron, and I'm going to bring one bond, two fingers, three fingers. Now they're all together, we get triple bonding. And this triple bonding is face to face of tetrahedron. So let me take regular tetrahedron, and I'm going to keep adding one to a face of tetrahedron, and you find they make an extraordinary thing, make a helix. And you find it takes exactly 10 tetrahedra to make one cycle of the helix. And the Watson, Crick, and Wilkerson's famous helix which you found you had in the RNA, DNA. It takes exactly 10 to make one cycle. Each one has 36 degrees when they get around. So suddenly realize, yes, there's tetrahedron maybe, and I call this the tetrahelix. There's much more to be understood here, and I might as well mention one, because it really is a form of fundamental disclosure, and one that's really given these men quite a lot of kick. Because they get really quite roughly to that 36 degrees, and they're not into things really fine enough. Incidentally, a tetrahedron can be regular or irregular. For instance, let's say each of the four triangles are a little different. The sums of the angles will still be 180 degrees for each of the triangles, so far it'd still be 720 degrees. So I find that I could, supposing I had G and C with a little different size, so one G is very big and C is not. Let me think of about a big sphere. There's nothing to stop a big sphere being tangent to a smaller sphere. They simply come together. Okay. There would still be, between the two of them, be a crotch where you could nest another sphere of another size. So I could have three spheres of different sizes, still all nesting together. I can have a fourth sphere nest in the, in this, but provided it wasn't so small it didn't fall through. So there would be a limit case test that can't fall through. Otherwise, it could be as large as you want. We can have really four sizes here, like a GC and a TA, where GC was one of two sizes and do various things. And you can really make your helix by repeating them. You can make helix do anything you want, because I find all design consists of only what's called angle and frequency modulation, starting with a known axis. And the axis is because there's always a tuneness, there will be an axis between two. So as you and I are talking now, there's an axis between us, so I can say, in relation to the axis between us, I go off at that angle. I go off at less frequency, 3 frequency, 5 frequency. Now, I change that frequency point to another angle. I can describe any geometry this way. I can describe all anything you make in nature. Angle and frequency modulation, I find that the tetrahedra allow me any angle and frequency modulation of GC and DA that I want to make any kind of anything you want. So this would then all coincide very nicely. But when I take a tetrahedron, I'm going to take the regular tetrahedron. It has its 6 edges, and have one of the edges facing towards you, so knife-like, a wedge. If I take a knife and cut into that, perpendicular into that edge, the way those two planes of the tetrahedron coming together, that edge, give me an angle. So if I cut in here as a cheese, I'd get an angle of a cheese here. This is called the dihedral angle, or the angle of two planes coming together. Now the dihedral angle of a tetrahedron is 70 degrees and 32 minutes. People who are metallurgists study when they have enormous impact on iron, cast iron or anything, they get a breaking shear. People are studying earth faults and earthquakes, find that all shear, what they call 110 degrees and 70 degrees, they have so total 180. They've identified, they don't have anything fine enough to identify as well. They get 70 degrees in 32 minutes and 109 degrees in 28 minutes. But it is, they call it 70 and 110. This is the dihedral of the tetrahedron. Now, but I know more enough about them, and I do my spherical trick, and I come down even finer than 70 degrees in 32 minutes, so many seconds, etc. It doesn't come out evenly because 360 degrees doesn't contain the integer 7 and several other prime numbers. Therefore, it can't come out even. It would come out even if you had comprehensive quotient, which was had all the prime numbers in there, would have to be involved.
It's a different number
base. Right. Now, and when nature plays her games with atoms, she comes out a whole number because she has comprehensive quotients that do accommodate. Okay. The 70 degrees and 32 minutes, the main thing, however, when I take tetrahedra and make them face to face like that, making the helix, I can make another helix of the tetrahedra. And you take two of these helixes, they look, they're winding like a twisting crawler. They do something very extraordinary, supposing, because you could have them wind right or you could have them wind left, but I'm going to take two rights. And two rights would do a very extraordinary thing, they nest right one another. Or making them out of paper, you find that's right. Make them out of steel. There's something you discover about them is they nest. They want to nest, they get right in, but not quite tight. So you have to, because the helix is long, you can, even made out of steel, you can just give it a little twist in and you can make them nest. As they want to nest in a very small fraction. Very attractive. Again, like the member has, where the excitement of just atomic, the periodic table and the proximity of the numbers to rationality and yet not explaining them. Here's something that surprises me, two helixes. I take two lefts, they'll match. Now, something we know about the helix and its control in DNA, which is that they do control life, and there is a mother, and the child mother comes off of it, comes right off the mold. But there's something very extraordinary. It's got something called, it unzips. It wants to have a dichotomy. Must break off, so the mother comes off, but comes off the same mold. So female isn't something else. It isn't right complementing a left. Right complements right. Okay. Now 70 degrees and 32 minutes is very interesting because supposing I took 5 tetrahedra, took the edge of the tetrahedron by 2 of its points, which are on the ends of any one of the edges and made that a vertical axis. I brought another tetrahedron up to that axis. I can bring five of them together. You'd have the number 70 degrees and 32 minutes times five. Quite clearly, seven times five is 35, so I said 70 degrees, so it gives me 350 degrees, and then five times 32 minutes gives you about 3 degrees more, so it is about 356 degrees. This is about a difference of approximately 4 degrees from 360. It isn't quite 360. There's just a tiny little gap. It's been always sort of annoying people. They thought maybe looking down, these five tetrahedra ought to go together, but no, there's always lacking 4 degrees. 4 degrees is a sort of annoying little amount. Now, I found that they were wrong with the tetrahelix. The tetrahelix doesn't make exactly one cycle in 10. It always is lacking that 4 degrees. For this reason, then, these two helixes won't quite nest. They're just lacking the 4 degrees, but there's something we call slenderness ratio, or relative cross-section to length of a column. The slenderness ratio is such in the tetrahelix column that there's enough flexibility in it, even in steel, so they will twist together. So you can make them fasten. But because of this 4 degrees, they want to unzip. And this is the very essence of why, then, life breaks off from life. Birth is right here.